So hopefully you now have a working tablet to work on, and in this video we're going to look at downloading and installing a digital art software. And there are so many different digital art softwares out there for you to download and use for your own work. And I know ConceptCookie is mostly known for Photoshop tutorials, but the differences between each of the softwares are so minimal that it doesn't really matter which software you're using, it's more of a personal preference. So here I have laid out six of the more well-known softwares that you can go ahead and download. And in the description, I'll put a link to each of them in case you want to go check them out even further. So in deciding what software may be best for you, you may want to look deeper into what features it offers that maybe another software doesn't. And I still recommend even trying out all of them because there might be something in one that you may really like, but the next one won't have. So although Photoshop has a monthly bill, it has a really nice layout and is probably the most widely known art software for concept artists. And if you don't want to download the entire Adobe suite, you can download just Photoshop for a monthly bill, and that is usually more cost efficient for most artists. Now, if you want to use an open source software, GIMP might be the right choice for you. So it's similar to Photoshop, but just has a few features that are just slightly different. Now, Sketchbook Pro also has a 3D integration where I've heard a lot of artists that are using it more to create like a grayscale environment first, and then we'll paint over. So that might be a nice fit for you if you're transitioning from 3D. And if you're an artist that really likes clean line work, so if you're working in animation, anime, or comic books, then PaintTool Sai might be the right software for you. They have a great feature that allows your brush strokes to slow down as you're drawing, and it gives really clean edges to it. And lastly, Corel Painter simulates traditional medias, so if you're someone that's looking to draw with acrylics or watercolor in a digital software, this might be the right one for you. So like I said, these are just six of the many different digital art softwares out there for you to go ahead and try. But these are definitely a good fundamental six for you to kind of feel out which ones you like more than others. So all digital art softwares will either be free to use or you have to pay to use it. So GIMP is a free to use software that you can pretty much use as soon as you install it. Whereas Photoshop, you have to buy it to use it. But all the ones that you have to buy to use, they usually offer a trial period for you to go ahead and kind of test out whether or not the software is right for you. So on the lower half of this handout, I have a step-by-step description of how to download and install the software correctly. So in this example, I used Photoshop, but they're relatively the same for each of those different softwares. So in this case, you would just find Photoshop.com. You would look through your website and then try to find where it says try and buy. And in this case, since it's a pay-to-use software, we could either do the free trial or buy now. And then once you go through all those steps, you would take then the steps to install it. And if you go through these steps and you're finding that it still isn't working, try troubleshooting. Google usually has most of the answers, but if you're still having trouble, you can either leave it in the comments section below or send an email to support@cgcookie.com and we'll make sure we'll get you started up and going right away. And in the next video, we're going to talk about the layout of the software and becoming more comfortable with that.